and testify about the 2012 terror attacks that killed 4 Americans, including the U.S. ambassador. The committee receiving 15,000 new documents during its third public hearing yesterday, but the chairman, Congressman Trey Gowdy, suggesting the Obama administration has been intentionally trying to slow walk this investigation. South Carolina Republican Congressman Trey Gowdy joins me now. Congressman, good morning. Good to have you here with us.
Thank you, ma'am.
So according to Congressman Elijah Cummings, he says Hillary Clinton is ready to testify for you anytime. So why not put her out there?
Well, I'm glad that Mr. Cummings changed his mind. In December, he was not saying that, but I do welcome change of heart. Martha, I can't examine any witness credibly unless I have emails and cables and documents. I can't bring a witness multiple times back and forth before any tribunal. I think the most expedient thing to do is to bring her once. And for me to bring her once, I need all of the documents that I would question her or ask her questions about in front of me. So as soon as the State Department complies with our request for documents, then we would be thrilled to have her come before the committee. So it's really in their hands.
You've said that the State Department's giving you more of a hard time than the DOJ in terms of turning stuff over. In these 15,000 documents, in the latest dump, what you need is not in there, are you saying that?
Well, 15,000 is great, but it's 15,000 out of how many? What I don't know is have they given us half the documents? Have they given us a fourth of the documents? What I do know is they have not given us all of the documents. There are several categories in which they have not fully complied, including, Martha, her emails. So if I were going to question you about any event, and I knew that there were emails or suspected that there were emails, I would need your emails to be able to have a constructive conversation with you. And it may be that the answer is they have given us all of them, but even they haven't said that. They've said it's still a work in progress. So, I mean, I would be a lousy lawyer if I tried to examine any witness before I had all the documents I needed to have a constructive conversation.
You know, what about the story a while back about documents being sifted through at the State Department over a weekend? There was testimony to that effect. What about talking to Cheryl Mills, who was supposedly present at that document sifting? Because it could be that some of what you're looking for simply isn't around anymore. Are you going to speak to Cheryl Mills? Are you going to speak to Susan Rice and question them as well?
All of the above. Now, the reasons to talk to Cheryl Mills would be, it would not just be the allegation of shifting through documents. And frankly, Martha, a serious committee and a serious investigation, when you have an allegation like that, you either corroborate the allegation or you contradict it. I mean, that's what investigations do. You don't just repeat a bald allegation that is as incendiary as that one. You either contradict it or you corroborate it. But there are myriad reasons to talk to Cheryl Mills. She was the top lieutenant for Secretary Clinton. And in a perfect world, you would interview Cheryl Mills before you interviewed Secretary Clinton. But I am willing to take the secretary as soon as the State Department produces documents. In other words, I'm willing to take her out of order. Right. I don't want this to drag into the fall. I was willing to do it in January.
But will you be speaking to Cheryl Mills or Susan Rice as part of this part of the investigation?
Absolutely.
All right.
You have to.
All right. So now there's the other side of this whole thing, which, of course, is the 2016 election. It would be understandable if Hillary Clinton wants to come before your committee, wants to say what she knows, and put this behind her so that it's not an issue for her anymore. It seems there's some politics being played here because you say, well, I'm not going to let her off the hook until I get what I want. And you know that she wants to be finished with this and put it behind her in time to have it not hanging over her head as she goes into the election.
Well, I don't know whether she's running or not. I suspect she is, but she hasn't said that she is. And frankly, whether or not she runs for president is none of my business as it relates to Benghazi. This is about her tenure as Secretary of State, not as a potential presidential candidate. I am willing to take her within 30 days of the State Department giving us the documents that we are entitled to. I don't know how I can be any more fair and less political about it than telling Mr. Cummings and the Democrats, we will take her, just give us 30 days to prepare after the documents are produced. But Martha, you would have me on your show citing me for legal malpractice if I examined a witness before I had the documents.
Understood. You know, in terms of the Democrats on this, because the whole thing was presented as a bipartisan committee to finally put to rest the questions surrounding Benghazi. Is that ever going to happen? Are Democrats looking for a way to drag this out so that there's never really any conclusion that's able to be reached that can be considered bipartisan?
Well, I think they have a two-pronged strategy. Number one is to try to create an environment where they can walk away and just walk away from the committee. And number two, if they can't do that, then to drag it out and delay it and then say you're getting involved in 2016 politics. But, Martha, keep in mind, all five voted against the committee. All five have at various times threatened to walk away. They put up a website that said ask and answer before we had our first hearing. They're complaining about the pace being too slow, but then when we want to have hearings about documents, they object to that. So color me a little suspicious when it comes to their wanting us to go ahead and get all the answers.
All right. Got your work cut out for you. Congressman, thank you very much. We look forward to hearing more from you as this moves forward. See you next time.
Thank you.
Many thanks.